Let's meet the CRL NA champions, Immortals.
And immortal they are. This powerhouse team closed out the NA regular season with a 10-4 record. They're always calm, they're always cool, they are always collected.
After so much success in the arena, they faced off in a final match against Complexity and brought it all the way to Game 4 of King of the Hill. Shockingly, it was, oh yeah, someone we hadn't really seen at all in the regular season who clinched their victory against Adrian Piedra.
I mean, they've got some very strong players on their roster. You've got Akrap and Nagataref, who've been a strong 2v2 duo, but are also stellar players separately as well. And then there's Royal, who's potentially the best player in CRL right now.
I mean, really, there's no question why they're heading to Tokyo. Their gameplay style is ruthless and calculated. They know what's in your deck, and they know how to build theirs to match. They're just unbreakable.
No doubt about it, Rich, but I want to go back to what you just said a moment ago about Royal. He's on top of the world right now with his regional finals win, and for good reason.
This star player on Immortals is nothing short of a royal pain in an opponent's butt. He is without a doubt the best player in CRL. Interestingly enough, he gets a lot of slack for being a golem player, but he's known for being able to play various decks and master new metas quickly. That's probably what makes Royal such a great player. He's adaptable and reactive, and you never know what cards he's got in his hands. It's why he finished 5th in CCGS Europe and why he made it all the way to LA for the 10 weeks of regular season. He went 12-2 in 1v1 sets and 28-11-2 draws in head-to-head games. And while he was doing all that, he managed to work his way up to 2nd place on the ladder. Can't wait to see what he brings to the arena in Tokyo.